Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's take a look at 10 Mac menu bar tips. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So Mac users use the menu bar every day, all day long. In this video, I'm going to focus on the main part of the menu bar, the left side here that has all of the different menus with different commands and menu bar items. My first tip is about the general use of the menu bar. There's actually two ways to use it. You probably use one without thinking about the fact that there is another. One method is to click to select a menu item and then release the mouse or trackpad and then click again to select the command. So for instance, I could go to View just by clicking once. And now I'm not holding down the mouse or trackpad anymore. I can navigate to what I want and click again to select the item. The other way to use it is to click and hold and continue to hold down the mouse or trackpad, get to the item you want, and then release. Neither one is the right way to use it. Some people prefer one or the other. Now you notice when you go to any menu here, you've got keyboard shortcuts shown to the right. And you can see them here with the special symbols that represent the different keys. For instance, this is the command key. This is the shift key. This is the control key. And down here you can see the option key. To improve your productivity, what you want to do is every time you use the menu, notice if there is a keyboard shortcut for that menu command. If this is something you use often, instead of actually using the menu, simply close the menu and instead use the keyboard shortcut. This takes more time, of course, but the idea is you're teaching yourself to use the keyboard shortcut rather than the menu. After doing that a few times, you remember the keyboard shortcut. In the end, the best way for you to operate is for the most common menu items to use the keyboard shortcut. And for everything else, don't worry about memorizing the shortcut and simply find it in the menu bar the next time you need it. Now, when you look at a menu, you don't see all of the commands that are available. If you hold down the Option key on your keyboard, you'll notice that some menu commands change. You can release the Option key and see it change back. You'll see the keyboard shortcuts change with it. So for instance here you could see that Get Info command I changes to Show Inspector Option command I when you hold down the Option key. But if you don't hold down the Option key to check out what's in that menu, you'll never know that Show Inspector is even available as a command. Sometimes the change is more subtle. For instance, here in the Apple menu, if I hold down the Option key, you'll see some of the menu items change slightly. Like for instance, look at Restart here. Without the Option key down, you can see it's Restart with three dots or an ellipsis after Restart. That means it's going to prompt me asking if it's okay to restart if I select this. But if I hold down the Option key, the ellipsis goes away and it just says Restart, which means it won't prompt me. It'll just instantly go into a restart. And sometimes menu items don't appear at all until you hold down the Option key. The most famous of those being right here in the Finder. If I look at the Go menu and then I hold down the Option key, I'll see the Library folder up here. It wasn't even there before without the Option key, but then it appears if you hold it down. This allows me to go to my library folder, which is normally hidden. Now many Mac users kind of ignore the last menu item here, Help. You click on it and you get Search and some links to some documentation. And you think searching just basically gives you more documentation. But actually it helps you find menu items. Any menu item here is going to show up when you search. So for instance, note how there's Use Groups here under View and under Sort By you can snap to grid. Well, if we go and Help here and type Groups, you could see that the first thing here is Menu Items. If I move my cursor over it, you can see it shows me where Use Groups is located. This is particularly useful if you can't find a menu item. It's hidden down into a submenu. So if you search for Snap, I could see Sort By Snap to Grid is hidden down in View, Sort By, and then Snap to Grid. It's easier to find by going to the Help menu and searching for Snap. I can actually select it here. I don't actually have to go to the menu there. So I'm both learning and getting a shortcut to that menu item. Now you don't have to click on the Help menu to use it. The keyboard shortcut for the Help menu is Shift, Command, and then the slash key, which in other words is kind of like Command question mark. And then instantly goes to the Help menu and puts the cursor right there in the search field. So I can now type what I want. I can down arrow to get to that item and then hit return to select that. As a matter of fact, using Shift Command slash is another way to access the menu bar by the keyboard. So I can do that. Now you can see the Help menu selected and I can start typing, but I could also use the left arrow to move through the different menu items, and the down arrow to go in and then return or space to select an item. By default, you can also use Control and F2 to access the menu bar. And you can see instead of selecting Help, it selects the Apple menu. And now I can use the arrow keys to move right and left and then down to select something. But my experience, Control F2 sometimes doesn't work, whereas Shift Command Slash always works. Now if there's a menu item that doesn't have a keyboard shortcut, you can assign one to it. So here under View, you can see Cleanup doesn't have a keyboard shortcut. Let's say that's something that you use a lot and you want a shortcut for it. You can go to System Preferences and then to Keyboard, then go to Shortcuts, and you can go to App Shortcuts and hit the plus button to add a shortcut for any menu. So the key is to type in the exact menu title. Don't worry about the menu itself. Worry about the exact menu item. That was View, Clean Up. Don't worry about the View part. It's just Clean Up that we need to specify. So here we'll type Clean Up, and it has to be exactly that menu name. Now we can select the application. Sometimes you want to do it for all applications if it's a common menu item. In this case, this is something specific to the Finder, so we'll choose Finder and we'll choose a keyboard shortcut. Let's do Shift Option Command U and add it. Now when I'm in the Finder here and I go to View, I can see Clean Up has Option Shift Command U as the keyboard shortcut. If I want to get rid of that, I can just look here in the App Shortcuts list and I should find it there. I can select it and change it. I can edit the name if I made a mistake, and I can also hit the minus button here to get rid of it. Now let's take a look at some other system preferences that affect the menu bar. If you go into System Preferences, General, there's an option here for automatically hide and show the menu bar. If you turn that on, the menu bar disappears at the top but will reappear if you move your cursor up there. So it gives you a little bit more space on your Mac screen. Also notice at the bottom here there's a recent items number. And you can set the number of recent items that you find here under Apple Menu Recent Items. This will show you things like recent applications, recent documents, and other things. So if you'd rather have only 5 recent items or maybe 15 or 50, you can change that. And here's a bonus tip. If you're in this menu and you hold the Command key down, it changes from actually running the app or opening the document to showing you where it is. So if I wanted to see where a particular item was, I just hold down the Command key, select it, and it will open that up in the Finder, just showing me the file, not opening it up. Another system preference you may want to check out is under Accessibility. If you go to Display, there's Reduced Transparency. The menu bar itself will seem to change color a little bit. It's actually revealing what's behind it on the screen. So in this case, part of this desktop image. Turn off Reduced Transparency, and now the menu bar becomes completely opaque. Now my last tip involves full screen windows. Whenever you go full screen, the menu bar goes away. A lot of people don't even realize they're doing this. They'll hit this green button here thinking, I just want the window to be as big as possible. But if you click it, you go into full screen mode. The menu bar is gone. It's still there if you move your cursor all the way to the top. It'll drop down. But people don't realize that they're now in full screen mode. They'll simply use the app like this for a while, click the green button, and it seems like the menu bar comes back. But what actually happens there is you're switching the window to full screen mode, which means full screen. So the menu bar isn't going to be in the way. If your goal is to actually have the window be as large as possible and still have the menu bar there, what you want to do is expand the window to full size by grabbing the corners and dragging. If you want a shortcut for that, all you need to do is hold the Option key down and double click on any one of the 4 corners of a window. And that will expand all 4 corners to fit the window perfectly and will keep the menu bar there. You're still in window mode. You can see that's still a window there, not full screen. But it is a way to have it be as large as possible and keep the menu bar on the screen at the same time. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.